Alright guys, so today we got a little bit of a different video. I'm gonna try this more like vlog style of doing my writing. And today we're gonna be talking about how revisions don't make your book any better. And that sounds like really bad, but I'm gonna sort of get into what I mean by that. Today we're gonna be in the lovely kitchen where all the writing magic happens, right at this little table here. I usually have some like tea or some chamomile with some like honey in it, and it's like really nice. And I get all of my writing done sort of at this like little dining table here. So that's where all the magic happens. Now I'm gonna get into why I don't think revisions are gonna make your book any better. I kind of use that as like a little thing to get you, so to get people to start watching. But the rest I'm gonna go through is sort of my goals for the whole month to like accomplish the rest of the things that I want to get done, and then also what it's going to be like with these vlogs going forward and how I think they're going to go. So here we are at the little workstation for where I get my like writing done, get into my headspace, get some tea and have a good time. I usually do my writing near the end of the day. Like the last thing that I do is my writing. That might change up, but the biggest thing that I'm doing right now is trying to have a schedule and really just stick with a disciplined sort of schedule. I got off on the wrong foot this week because my friends were having a party here at the house and I was trying to get some sleep, but they were a little loud. It was okay. I got started a little bit later, but you know, it's not about getting defeated and not trying to do it, like start up the regimen again, but it's about tomorrow I'm gonna start the regimen up and I'm gonna like keep trying to stick with it. So my regimen, I'll get into that next week, but what we're here to talk about is how revisions will not make your book better. As you know, I'm in the process of writing my first book right now and it's had a lot of challenges. Little debrief is I made a resolution this year in January that I'm gonna write my first book, and then in March I was able to start it and I had to take a break in June. I had around 30 to 40,000 words. And then because I was moving in June and all, and I started a YouTube channel and everything was kind of crazy, I picked it up right back in sort of like September, October. And now I have a goal of finishing this book by the end of November. So about 60,000 words in a month and a half, basically, which is totally accomplishable. But there's a lot of nuances to my process and why I'm sort of talking about why revisions don't work. First of them being is revisions are great for a book. You need to be able to do revisions, but if you do not have good character motivations, a good character arc, and a good plot that's all working to your favor, then you're gonna struggle with your revisions. For me right now, I'm also the sort of person that's like, I need to have it perfectly done the first time or to the best of its ability by the first time it's done. And that's just not how writing is. Like, you need to be able to just sit down with the book and really explore it and figure it out. I'm an architect. That's sort of my like writing style. So I like to really plot it out, have it all figured out. But I also, when I started this process, I didn't know what I was getting into. This is my first book. So I started writing the book, and even though I had this very good obviously it wasn't a good outline. Even though I had this outline, I had very poor character motivations, and now my character's motivations have changed throughout my process of writing it. So I don't know if that's just me, where it's like through my process of writing, I actually figure out what I want to tell, and then I come up with better ideas as I'm writing, and then I just have to like go back to the outline stage. I'm struggling with just finishing the book. So even though I have these cooler ideas, even though I have better character motivations, even though I have better scenes now, I still have not been able to finish the book because I'm stuck on the first two or three parts that it's like getting through the book and getting through the character arcs, where I should just finish the book and then go back and revise. And that's one of the things that I'm learning right now, because it's hard, right? It's hard because my character motivations and my ending has changed so much that if I just kept writing, the first half of the book and the second half of the book would make no sense. So if I tried to like go through and revise it, I would basically have to change everything anyway. So that's why it's like really important to have very good character motivations, stick with those motivations and stick with the plot beats and finish out the book and then relook at it and try to get through it. For me, I didn't do that. And it's causing a lot of problems right now, and it's enabling me from finishing the actual book. So I know once I finish my revisions of part 1 through 3, I'm gonna outline part 4 and 5 in November, the beginning of November. And then I'm gonna stick with it. Like, just stay with it and just finish the book. And I'm gonna give myself the time in December, that whole month, to be able to revise whatever I want, whatever I think is different, or whatever I wanna change. So that's my big thing. Revisions don't necessarily make your book better, and you're gonna keep running in circles, constantly trying to revise a scene, where it's just like, you just need to finish the book and you need to get it all done, and then you can go back and maybe re-outline or try to find better character motivations, and then go back and start revising, because revising is obviously very important. I'm on the opposite end of the spectrum, where Brandon says when he started out his writing, he didn't really do a lot of revising. He just wrote it and then would go to another project, and he didn't really have beta readers. So that's one of the things that I'm trying to like stay on top of early on in my career, is have beta readers and then revise. And I've sort of gone to the opposite end of that, where it's hindering me, where I do way too many revisions and it's not really helpful. But I'm learning, right? I'm learning my sort of writing style. I tried to copy Brandon's. When I first started my writing, I was copying George R. R. Martin's, and I had to abandon that project because I was like, I have no idea where I'm going, because he's a gardener. And then I was like, okay, I'm gonna try Brandon. I really look up to Brandon and he's my favorite author. So I'm like, I'm gonna try his sort of stuff. So I'm gonna be more of an architect, really outline it. And I think for most people, you find yourself somewhere in the middle. I definitely see myself as a outliner, and then as I'm writing, I'm sort of a gardener, because I go different routes and I find better scenes, and I really just let the book sort of like speak to me, I guess, very ethereal, but I really like it. I need to just figure out a good middle where I don't have to go back and revise this much because I don't have a good outline. But that's enough like rambling for me. I'm gonna show you guys sort of like what I'm gonna be working through in like the next few chapters, and then how I'm going to be finishing the rest of the book. But in brief, basically, I am going to be doing my vlog on a day-to-day basis from here on out. I'm sort of just like trying to figure out the vlog style and what I want to do. But my next episode is going to be sort of my daily routine, how I'm like trying to stick with it, how I'm coming along in my book. I'll probably maybe show off a few scenes and maybe talk about them. But it's mainly going to be about how I have a disciplined, or how I'm trying to form a disciplined sort of schedule to be able to stay on top of my writing and keep going with it. This one's just sort of like, I had my introduction video before. This one's sort of like what I'm learning right now. And I just wanted to give a little like vlog about that. But vlogs from here on out, I want them to be more of like a little day-to-day of how my writing is going or what's going on next, and then hopefully get some advice or talk about what I'm learning and get some input from you guys. But let me just show you guys like a little schedule that I have of how I think the book is going to be finished and how I'm planning on being disciplined to be able to get it done. So I sort of broken down my week and just like, here's everything I need to accomplish in one day, and that's sort of just starting to help me really get organized in my head and not have myself too overwhelmed about the big obstacle of finishing a book. But I bunched these chapters up because they're already written. I just need to like revise them a little bit. So that's Monday. And then same with this one. These chapters are already done. I just need to go back and revise, and I'll finish part one on Tuesday. And then chapter 9 through 12 are already written. That's starting part two, and I will get those done pretty fast because they're already written. Now, when I get to chapter 13 and 14, basically all the way up until 19, which is the end of part two and the beginning of part three, which is further down here. I need to really, those are chapters that are not written yet. It's sort of the middle part of the book where I need to figure out better character motivation. And I've given myself a day to be able to finish those, but I will be writing every single day. And then on Thursday of next week, I'll be in part three, which part three is basically almost all the way written. I believe the ending, like the middle to ending of part three, is already done. So I'll finish those up by the beginning of November. And then November, I will outline part four and part five. And then in November, like the middle part of November, I'm gonna write part four, because it'll be around 9 to 10 chapters. And then the end of November will be part five, and that'll be like 8 or 9 chapters. So I'll be finishing those up near the end of November. But that is in essence like sort of my goals and how I'm planning on to accomplishing them and getting through them. And finishing this first book is gonna teach me a lot, and I'm really excited. And I'm excited to bring you guys along for the journey. So if there's anything you want me to talk about in the upcoming videos for my vlogs or anything like that, you just let me know. But for now, I'm just gonna be documenting sort of my writing journey. Thanks for coming along, and I'll see you guys in the next video.